you guys want to know how I film my intros to these videos, I just put this music on and I move to it. I literally look naked. Let me zoom you guys out so you guys can see that I really am dressed, guys. What's up, guys? So I was waiting for it to stop pouring down raining outside, but it literally is never, like, do you hear that? A lot of you guys were asking me in my last video what happened to my car, because when I was filming, my top was down, blah, blah, blah. I have a convertible and water is actually leaking in through my convertible and has soaked the inside of my car. And because it rains every single day, it doesn't ever get better. So yeah, my car is currently full of water a little bit, but it's fine. I was doing my makeup yesterday, and as I was doing it, I was like, wow, this makeup would be so pretty if I like went on a date somewhere, like to a nice restaurant or something. And then I was like, I don't go on dates. Let's just get started because I'm kind of done just rambling about me being single. So I am using the Pore Vanishing Moisturizer. This is a matte hydrating primer, which is really weird because when I found this, by the way, it's from Estee Lauder. It's like Estee Edit, I believe. Yeah. When I found this, I was like, how is this pore minimizing and moisturizing? Because normally if you have a pore minimizing primer, it feels like you can feel the difference. But this, why is my face just like getting red? That was really weird, right, guys? Okay. Anyway, this one you can actually tell it really is moisturizing my skin, but at the same time, it's like good at burning, getting rid of all my pores. You know, if you're on a date, you don't want them to know you have pores, so you have to use a pore minimizing primer to make it look like they're not even there. The next thing is the Urban Decay All Nighter Waterproof Long Wear Liquid Foundation. This is for, one, if it's pouring raining outside and you can hear the rain. Two, if you guys are going on a date, you want to have waterproof, long wear, full coverage foundation. They are never gonna know what your skin looks like underneath. This stuff goes a long way. The first time I used it, I pumped like 4 pumps on my hand, and I literally need like half a pump. I'm gonna do it once. Oh, that honestly it could have been too much. It literally goes so far. Okay, my foundation's on. It was just raining so loud that I couldn't even talk while doing my foundation. So yeah, that's that. I know it looks really dark, but it always does. Before I put my concealer on, it's gonna be fine. We're gonna live, guys. Next we're gonna do is take this Urban Decay concealer, and we are just gonna conceal all of my insecurities away, because no one likes an insecure date, okay? So I want to know if any of you guys have ever been on like a really terrible date, or like it was really, like it was just really bad in general. I mean, I've never really been on like a really bad date. I've had some awkward dates before. Like, it was just like, please get me out of here. But I want to know if you guys have been like really, really bad dates. Comment in the comments down below and let me know what's like the worst date you guys have ever been on. My ideal date is like Chick-fil-A. Also, I'm wearing hoops because you know what they say, the bigger the hoop. I don't know why I'm like this. No, but honestly, I literally wear hoops like every single day of my life. Like, I will wear hoops with like a big t-shirt. Like, I will wear Nike shorts or like Lulu leggings and like hoops and a t-shirt. Like, I don't know why, but it's like, I don't know what, like, I don't know what other earrings do you wear if you're not wearing hoops, you know? I'm not a stud kind of gal. Definitely, I'm a hoop ho. I'm a hoop ho. Now, to be more dramatic, if you're on a date and it's like the first time you're meeting them, you really don't want them to know that you don't have cheekbones. So we're gonna contour. See, it's not like a like really aggressive contour. It's just like a little something to make it look like my face is a little slimmer than it really, really is. I'm using my Laura Mercier translucent powder to bake underneath my eyes and set my forehead and my chin, because when I get like scared and nervous, I start sweating, and I would definitely be sweating on a date. So I need to set that, because if they see an oily chin, they're never gonna date me. The lighting in this room keeps changing. It's really weird because now it's making me look like red and orange. In real life, I'm not this color. Ugh. Okay, I'm gonna fill my brows in really quickly with the Anastasia soft brown eye pencil. Also, like, I'm not even like bitter or anything that I don't go on dates. Like, I'm not even mad about it. Like, I'm not even hurt. I just got foundation all over. Not even hurt, not even mad. If you're about to go on a date and you're feeling really nervous, you need to just turn some jams on and like get it together, because you can't be like that on a date. Let's just. Okay, I'm gonna pause the jams because the eyeshadow for this look is probably like my favorite thing. So I'm actually using the new ColourPop I Love Sarah. I think this is a collab with someone on social media. I'm so sorry, I don't know. But her name is I Love Sarah, I believe. And I got this in the mail and I was so happy because these shades are so pretty. I know they look really like basic, but there's like a setting shade. There's a highlighting shade. This is like a crease shade. Well, this is how I use it. And then that, I deepen my crease up. So that's what we're gonna do. Okay, I feel like this is a little better. I feel like you guys get the gist more. But basically, I'm literally just adding in this light brown shade in the crease. Then I'm gonna go in with this one. It looks brown, but it's actually almost like plum, if that makes sense. And I'm gonna put this in the crease, and then, or I'm gonna put this in the corner and the crease. So I set it right there, concentrating it there, and then I'm gonna blend it. Like, do people still go on dates? Like, do people go out to dinner? Like, do people say, hi, can I take you on a date? Because I feel like that's literally non-existent. And if it does exist, they're probably a pedophile. Now I'm gonna take this shade right here. It's like shimmery. It almost has a little bit of pink in it, but when you put it on the lid, you can't really tell. So I'm gonna put it in the inner corner because that's where he needs to be looking. That's where my date needs to be looking. Into my eyes. Now I'm gonna take the same dark shade right there, and I'm going to smudge out my lower lash line because that just makes this look a lot better. So that is the eyeshadow. Lately, I've been using the Urban Decay Glide On Pencil in Sabbath, which is a navy eyeliner, which I know is kind of a weird color, but I have bluish like green eyes, and I feel like the navy really, really helps my eyes pop, like no matter what look I'm doing. I know it's such a weird like liner color to go with this, but I did it yesterday and it looks really good, so I'm gonna do it again. Like, do you see the difference in this mascara? Like, the difference that it made in my lashes? It's honestly amazing, and it's so, like, black. For bronzer, I've been using this combo for, like, forever, so I'm gonna use, why was I looking at them? Like, I don't even know what they are. The Smashbox Starburst, like, highlighting thing, and then the Becca bronzer in Panama Sun, which is a super, super dark shade, but we gonna do it. This is the best song to play if you are not feeling yourself or you're about to go on a date and you need to start feeling yourself. For blush, I'm using like an oldie but a goodie. I haven't used this in forever. This is the Sigma blush in Corderosa, I think so. I don't know, but it's really, really pretty. Natural blush, because the eyes are so dark, I like don't really feel the need to put a dark blush on. This is for you, Kels. This song is for you. You say I'm wrong cause I cheated out of spite. I say you wrong cause you cheated every night. So if he a dog, I'm a dog too. Okay, so for lips, I was really debating. Yesterday, I wore this lip combo, and this is also from the I Love Sarah ColourPop collection. I feel like I want to go with the dark lip, so that's what we're going to do. So this is just a lip liner, and I actually love this color. Like, it looks so, so good. So I'm going to add the ultra matte lip. This is in the shade Mamacita. Ooh. So this is the final look. So I actually really, really love this look. You don't have to wear this on a date. You can wear it on a date. I'm obviously not wearing it on a date. I'm just wearing it, you know, in the middle of the day. It's literally like 10 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, it's 10 o'clock in the morning, and I'm just wearing this makeup. So you guys can recreate this look. I will leave all the makeup down below. If you guys like this look, you guys want to see more videos like this, please, please, please give it a thumbs up, because that really lets me know that you guys like this. Don't forget to comment your worst dating experience, like your worst date you've ever been on. Please comment it in the comments down below. If you guys aren't already, you guys should definitely follow me on my Instagram and Twitter. I'm super, super active on there. I think that's it for this week's video, and I will see you guys next week.